Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the video, you can press the like button, share the video with your friends so that they can be benefited. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for sure. See, because whenever you subscribe, obviously you will be getting the notification of such kind of videos. And I would appreciate if you subscribe because you will be getting the notification of all the exam relevant videos every time whenever we upload a new video. So this video is relevant for almost all the competitive exam, because exams as the section of current affairs, that's almost common, that's there in almost all the exams. So we are starting from the very first question. Stay put, stick to the video, watch till the end, because whenever I'm about to wrap up the video, I get the revision done. That's very important for you. That's how you can keep all the points in your mind. First, we'll start with table tennis. What's that table tennis? You can see the racket in the hand of the person who's sitting. We are talking about Sathya Nanasekharan. He's from Tamil Nadu. And he won gold at men's singles, gold in the category of men's singles at ITTF Challenge Spanish Open. And what is that ITTF? When you expand it, that becomes International Table Tennis Federation. International Table Tennis Federation Challenge, that's Spanish Open. And Sathyan Nanasekharan of Tamil Nadu won that ITTF Challenge Spanish Open. He won gold in men's singles. He won gold in men's singles category. So I'm saying Spanish Open, ITTF Challenge Spanish Open, Sathyan Nanasekharan of Tamil Nadu won gold. Union Minister, alright. Which Union Minister are we referring to? We are referring to Menaka Gandhi. And what has she started now? She has started one program to train elected women representatives of Panchayati Raj institutions. As you can understand, there's a Panchayati Raj system in India. So when we refer to PRI, that means Panchayati Raj institutions, there are elected women sarpanchs, representative. There's a Hindi word for it. That's sarpanch, the one who heads, the one who's the head in Panchayat. So we are saying that if there is a woman sarpanch, they don't actually go there and sit as the representative, sit as the sarpanch. They send their husbands in place of them. That means they don't prefer attending those hearings which happen at their places. They are the heads. Obviously, they need to cast their opinion. They don't do that. They generally send their husbands in place of them. So such people, like such women who are involved, they are working, they are basically the elected women representatives in the panchayat, in the panchayat. So I am saying, so those women who are leading, but they don't actually take the responsibility rather seriously because they send their husbands in place of them. Just to curtail that, such initiative, such program is going to help them. And all these women representatives in Panchayati Raj institutions, they'll be trained for it. So I'm saying Menaka Gandhi is the union minister who has launched an intensive program to train elected women representatives of Panchayati Raj institutions. All right, the next question is that Axis Bank is, you know, has started something new. And what's that? When you talk about wallet, when you talk about any wallet banking like Paytm or something like that. So I'm saying everybody is doing that. So a little bit change is there. Now it is Ripple Card Instant Payment. You can see the logo of Ripple here and Axis Bank here. So Axis Bank is going to start Ripple Card Instant Payment Service. But this, you know, something new here. That's for the retail and corporate customers only. A little bit changes there whenever they launch something. So Axis Bank has started for the retail and corporate customers, Ripple Card Instant Payment Service. So Ripple Card Instant Payment Service started by Axis Bank. For whom? For retail and the corporate customers. Okay, because he has become the first Indian man who won Asian Marathon Championship, that's Gopi Thonakal. He is from Kerala and he has become the first. That's important. The first Indian, for the first time, first Indian who won Asian Marathon Championship. Asian Marathon Championship, we are referring to Gopi Thonakal, and he's from Kerala. And you need to know the name of the person. You need to keep the place where he belongs to. That should be kept in your mind all the time. That's Gopi Thonakal. He's from Kerala and he has won Asian Marathon Championship. Women's singles title at Hong Kong Super Series Badminton Tournament 2017, won by Tai Zhu Ying. Tai Zhu Ying won Hong Kong Super Series Badminton Tournament. All right. Now we are going to talk about Kidambi Srikanth. Kidambi Srikanth, he has won Sportsman of the Year Award. Sportsman of the Year Award at the first edition of Indian Sports Honours. See, if there is a title called Sportsman of the Year, there has to be a title of Sportswoman of the Year. And if we refer to Sportswoman of the Year, that's PV Sindhu. First edition is important. That means it was given first time. We are referring to Indian Sports Honours 2017 for the first time. And Sportsman of the Year, Kidambi Srikanth, Sportswoman of the Year, that's PV Sindhu. So that's the first edition, first time Indian Sports Honours held, and we are saying Sportsman of the Year went to Kidambi Srikanth. Mr. Narendra Modi inaugurated 8th edition of the Global Entrepreneurship Summit. This event has become popular. Why? Because Ivanka Trump was there. Who's Ivanka Trump? She's the daughter of Donald Trump. So we are saying 8th edition, the number is important. Who was the guest? That's Ivanka Trump, who inaugurated Ivanka Trump and Mr. Modi himself. And where did it take place? The place was Hyderabad. And what was that? That was Global Entrepreneurship Summit. Global Entrepreneurship Summit, 8th edition, held in Hyderabad, inaugurated by Mr. Modi and Ivanka Trump. India has recently signed an anti-terror pact to help each other in combating terrorism with Russia. As you know, every country is facing terrorism. So just to fight that, India has signed a pact with Russia. So India and Russia, they've signed a pact, anti-terror pact, because they are going to help, you know, each other. India and Russia, they're going to help each other. They'll fight terrorism. Karen Pierce, what's special about her? The special thing is, in United Nations, the delegation is done by the ambassadors of the nations. In United Nations, the delegation is done by the ambassadors of different nations. When it comes to UK, we have not seen any female yet. Now we are saying that there's a female here, that's Karen Pierce, and that's first ever female ambassador of UK to United Nations, and her name is Karen Pierce. Karen Pierce, first female ambassador of UK to United Nations. Nirmala Sitharaman became the new president of Institute of Defence Studies and Analysis. Institute for Defence Studies and Analysis. Institute for Defence Studies and Analysis, Nirmala Sitharaman. Now, what's special about Mr. Shaktikanta Das? He was basically the former Economic Affairs Secretary. So it is, you know, a great rank to you know, hold. Former Economic Affairs Secretary, Shaktikanta Das. So Mr. Das has been appointed as India's G20 Sherpa for the development track of the G20 summit. Please understand, when we refer to G20 summit, if the summit is about to happen, we need to have somebody who can make the prior arrangements. Let's say what should be, see, the preparatory work has to happen before, you know, the start of the summit. So who's going to do the preparatory work before the start? That's Mr. Shaktikanta Das. So India's G20 Sherpa. See, I'm not calling it Sherpa, as you guys know, and you guys call them Sherpa by saying that they are mountaineers and expert climbers and all. I understand that, but there's another meaning of the word Sherpa. That's a civil servant or diplomat who undertakes preparatory work prior to a summit conference. So I'm saying Sherpa is a civil servant or a diplomat who undertakes preparatory work. That's what I was telling you. If the summit is about to happen, who's going to do the preparatory work? That's Sherpa. and that India's G20 Sherpa, Mr. Shakti Kanta Das, for the development track of the G20 summit. And he was like erstwhile Economic Affairs Secretary also. So new CMD, Chairman and Managing Director of Air India, Pradeep Singh Kharola. New Chairman and Managing Director of Air India, Pradeep Singh Kharola. Pradeep Singh Kharola. Inspire 2017 started in Jaipur. And what's that Inspire? That was the first edition of Inspire. Important. Held, started in Jaipur. Now we need to say that international, that's Inspire Symposium, Conference, Discussion Symposium, to promote innovation and research in energy efficiency. That's Inspire. So international conversation, discussion. So we are saying international symposium to promote innovation and research in energy efficiency has started in Jaipur. Beyonce. When we talk about Beyonce, we all know her. There's, you know, you need not learn the name as you are familiar with her. I'm saying that she has been named 2017's highest paid woman. Not, you know, that's not according to us. That's according to Forbes. They release the data. They release the data like who's highest paid. When we talk about highest paid, that too in music, as you know her. So we are saying that in music, she's the highest paid woman according to Forbes. That's Beyonce. We're starting the revision. Let's start. All right. The first question, ITTF, Challenge Spanish Open. That was International Table Tennis Federation, won by Sathya Nanashekharan of Tamil Nadu. He won gold at the Spanish Open in men's singles category. When we talk about Panchayati Raj institutions, elected women representatives are there, but they don't perform their duties well. At times, they don't even attend the sessions of Panchayat. So they are, you know, getting trained by this program. And what is that intensive program? It was launched by Miss Menaka Gandhi. She's the union minister, basically. So the bank, which has launched it, Ripple Part Instant Payment Service. So the bank, Axis Bank, has launched Ripple Part Instant Payment Service, but that's for retail and corporate customers. We're talking about Axis Bank, Gopi Thonakal of Kerala. He has become the first Indian man to win Asian Marathon Championship. Hong Kong Super Series Badminton Tournament 2017, won by Tai Zhu Ying. She won the women's singles. Sportsman of the Year in Indian Sports Honours, first edition held. And we are saying Kidambi Srikanth became or got the title of Sportsman of the Year. Global Entrepreneurship Summit, held in Hyderabad, attended by Mr. Modi and Ivanka Trump. And we are saying that was the 8th edition. It was inaugurated by both of them. Rather, we'll prefer our Prime Minister only. So India has recently signed an anti-terror pact with Russia. Karen Pierce, she is the first female ambassador of UK, to United Nations. So for United Nations, the first lady from UK, she's the ambassador of UK and she's going to represent UK in United Nations and her name is Karen Pierce. Nirmala Sitharaman, she has been elected as the new president of Institute for Defence Studies and Analysis. Shakti Kanta Das has been appointed as India's G20 Sherpa for the development track of G20 summit. New CMD of Air India, Pradeep Singh Kharola. Inspire, held in Jaipur, and that was the first edition of it. Beyonce, according to Forbes, highest paid woman. According to Forbes, 2017's data. So we are referring to the music, basically. Highest paid woman in music. That's Beyonce. We are wrapping it up. Thank you so much.